Hi everyone, welcome to Stitching It. Today is an exciting day because I am here with Diana, if you don't know her, from Itiskismet Stitches.
Hi.
And she is here with me today at a get-together of the Georgia Cross Stitchers. But we have something to share with you guys today that is not cross-stitching related. So I would like to take a few minutes to show you guys a finish, a very, very special finish that we've done, and I hope you guys will enjoy it. I originally saw this project at a retreat. I saw it and immediately fell in love with it because it looked so different from most needlepoint or canvas projects that I had seen. So I wanted to pick it, and the more I worked with it and started seeing the threads and stuff, I just loved it, and I decided to stitch it for my anniversary, which is coming up in a couple days. You'll see that this design is very much similar to a quilt, and the squares of it reminded me, and I immediately started thinking, well, great, it would be such a great thing to have a quilt to match this canvas piece. So last year I immediately thought of Diana and asked if she would be willing to make a coordinating quilt to go with this project for my bedroom. We had just gotten a new bed as a new married couple, and I really wanted to make it personalized and something special for us to have. So it's right here behind me on the table, and I haven't even seen it yet, and I'm very excited to show you guys not only the finish that I did, but I mean just the fantastic work that she has put into this and done. And I hope to ask her a few questions about how she got it all done. Diana, I had a specific design kind of in mind when I came to you asking about a quilt.
Yes.
And you, so you didn't have to come up with something,
Not completely from scratch.
Not completely.
I didn't have to come up with a complete original design for it, since you already had the template of your stitched piece.
Mm-hmm.
But we still did get together and kind of talk about colors and how we wanted to put it together. And I think what you had ultimately decided was that you had wanted the inverse of the counted canvas piece.
Yes.
So the heart itself would be made up of the colors, the pink and purple and tealy colors that are in the needlepoint piece, and that the backgrounds would be the neutral colors.
Mm-hmm.
Because then, you know, it would actually seem more like bedding then. And
right.
I think that ended up working out for the best.
Mm-hmm.
And I did modify a little bit the look of the design so that the heart would actually look more like a heart and less like a little, you know, like a stepped heart. So I think at the end, it's going to be a good interpretation of the needlework piece, and I think it's going to go well together, especially once we settled on the teal-colored binding, because in my opinion, I think that's what really makes it pop.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm excited. I haven't seen the inside yet. This is just the back, but I've seen some progress pics along the way, which I'll probably put in to show you guys. But what would you say, like, what was the hardest thing about doing a quilt, you know, this size?
I'd never made an actual bed size quilt, and to boot, this one was king size.
Yeah.
So I think after you start putting blocks together and rows together, you start seeing how kind of unwieldy it becomes. So you really have to be deliberate about every seam that you sew and how you decide to put it together, because you need to have room for it. Yeah, so one of the challenging aspects of it is actually having to plan a lot beforehand, because I tend to be a little bit of a fly-by-the-seat-of-my-pants type person, even when I have a pattern. So I usually just kind of like make it work for me. But for this one, I had to be a lot more deliberate about placement and the actual construction of it. And once I realized how big it was going to be, the other discussion that we had was that we were going to have somebody else quilt it. Because to do it on a domestic machine, which is a regular home sewing machine, would be very difficult, you know, for
right.
a quilt of this size.
Right. So if someone was, I mean, just for, that's definitely, I mean, yeah, I didn't even want to try to do it on my own. But for someone who is just starting to make quilts out, I know, I mean, for example, I'm just going to open this up and show a little bit, a little teaser of, you know, this is what I think of like a traditional quilt, you know, these squares, these blocks like that.
A patchwork.
Mm-hmm. Is that what a patchwork quilt would be called? But, you know, when I think also of a quilt, you know, a lot of times I think of the blocks themselves, you know, the individual blocks. And I had, you know, I didn't know if you, which is harder, I mean, like, to be able to do one big design, do you think, like this was, or if you had done the individual blocks?
I think that each quilt kind of has its own things that are easy and its own things that are challenging. For this one, since it was going to be so big, I wanted to find a good balance. One, I wanted to focus on what the final product was going to look like. And I knew that things that maybe were small, fiddly, more detail focused would probably get lost on a project of this scale. So I just wanted to focus more on color and making sure that everything that I put in it worked well together for balance. And you'll see that even if this is a simpler patchwork, for the colored blocks, I did include a little bit of variety so that you can kind of mimic or mirror the look of your stitched piece.
Mm-hmm. I mean, I'm floored, and you know, I love that you just did a lot of things to really put variety in those neutrals. That's all I can see so far, and so I'm excited. We're gonna take this upstairs and find a good place to display it so we can show you the whole entire thing. And wow, I mean, I'm just...
And then you can use it.
Yes, I get to put it on my bed tonight and celebrate. If you could take a minute and tell me a little bit about the fabric choices that you came up with, that would
sure thing. I got some screenshots of the stitched piece that you were working on, and I kind of focused on that as my color palette. I saw that there were soft pinks, bright pinks, and purples. And just different variations of those shades. So I wanted to make sure that I got a full like spectrum of the pinks and the purples that you had asked for. So I really went to a few different quilt shops, and I focused on getting smaller cuts of fabric. So I think I got quarter yards. And what that allowed me to do was to get a very, to get a good variety of prints included in there. And what it also allowed me to do was to make use of the smaller pieces. So you'll see some of the blocks have like little patchworks or half square triangles, or they're put together with a few different kinds of fabric. And that's that I made use of pretty much all the scraps. There was very little waste for this quilt. So are you ready to celebrate your anniversary?
It looks amazing. I'm ready to celebrate my anniversary with this quilt, under this quilt. Thank you very much, Diana.
Well, it was really my pleasure.
Amazing. So
I had a lot of fun, and your idea was great, and I love how everything came together. Now you have your stitched piece and your quilt.
I really appreciate it. So wow, it's amazing. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you guys next time.